Today I'm going to show you some magic with my magic wand, and this is just a plastic PVC pipe and my yarn. When I bring this together, see, nothing happens. So now let me rub up, and I'm rubbing it in one direction. See what happens. This is the magic Indian rope trick. The cola can is obviously heavier than the yarn, and it also needs to overcome the friction on the table surface. Yet look at how strong the force of attraction is that we can move it all along the table surface. This is like a magician wand attracting the can with invisible forces. So my wand can attract even the plastic bottles, and it doesn't have to be only metal surfaces that it can attract. Well, this might look like magic, but it is not. So let's look at the science behind it. When two materials come into contact, one of them being an insulator, some of the electrons get transferred from one to the other, leaving one guy positively charged and the other guy equally negatively charged, and hence they attract each other. You might think that these forces can attract only light materials. So let's see if these forces can attract heavy metals also. As you can see, a much heavier can gets attracted towards this pipe when I rub it with a shawl and charge it. Let's try to do a magic wand now. We've now set up the cans side by side with enough space between them so that our magic wand can go comfortably between them. Now let's see what happens when we charge our magic wand. Oh, so now both the cans, you can see, are attracted towards the pipe. Look at how far they get attracted. So as you can see, the static charge can be pretty large to attract two cans. So if a 2 gram can deviated for about 3 degrees, what is the amount of the static force that we generated in our PVC pipe? Send us your answers at support@arvindguptatoys.com or as comments on Facebook or YouTube. Thank you.